Hey everyone, it's me, Fresh X Champ Golden Express 1999. Before I get started with this new video, I would like to know that some of you might be like missing my See Me voice videos. That's because, well, I've been having some time off figuring out what cool things, what newer, cooler, better things I can come up with, as usual. But I'm just trying to like take it easy, and I promised you that I will come up with something awesome. But speaking of awesome, I'd like to present to you a video of how I chose animation. For my dream job, of course, obviously. Since I was about 5 to 6 years old, while experiencing the special features on the DVDs of Ice Age The Meltdown, I saw the many wonders of the concept art by Peter Tsev, the computer-generated animation, music, and the voices, and so much more to learn. But before this happened, I'd always see these promos and bumpers from Nickelodeon and Cartoon Network, respectively. But Nickelodeon, it featured stuff like how to draw characters, tips on making your own cartoon show, and the like. Once I reached my teen phase, I got to know the adult animated sitcom called South Park and how it was made. And around that time, I fell in love with the show, and in the process, it inspired me to make my possible future animated series. Not just one, but just as much as I can think of until I run out of ideas. The behind-the-scenes features from nearly anything often came in handy for me to help inspire me also. One of the elementary schools that I was attending at the time, way back, was Rudy Elementary when I lived in Colorado. One day, we each brought a book and take turns reading it in front of the class, and mine was Little Bill, The Day I Saw My Father Cry. And while reading a book as usual like anybody else would, it wasn't until my mom gave me advice on using a different voice whenever a character talks. It was strange to me at first, but then, once I got over it, the results, well, they were surprisingly interesting, though. It changed my life. Forever. The aforementioned Nickelodeon bumpers also featured Tom Kenny, the voice of SpongeBob, and then, as soon as I got introduced to him, I soon began to love and appreciate many other voiceover artists, such as Tara Strong, James Arnold Taylor, Kevin Michael Richardson, Mel Blanc, etc., etc. And soon, I was thinking, wow, people can actually do this as a living and get paid for it? So I thought, this is the most easiest job in the world for anyone. Anybody can do it. It's just the same as acting, but you can use your voice. And that takes talent.
It's all coming together. It's all coming together. This is it. Our vision. Come to life.
I know.
Due to my great handwriting and skill with thinking about just the perfect things to prove a point while writing a sentence or something given to me in school, in some classes, I believe that I can be a writer, mostly because I could be able to come up with the funniest lines from watching hilarious comedy movies, any TV show, and, surprise, surprise, my parents, even though they're not really comedians. But still, people give awards from that, so I'm determined not to make any dialogue that's cringy, controversial, or plain bad. The many keys from watching and listening how it's done right for anybody. The fun thing about animation is choosing which type of show that it's going to be and how much you can have fun with it just from working on it. For me, I choose stuff like comedy, action, adventure, superhero, and drama. And if I were to make movies, I would choose horror, biography, buddy comedy, and documentary. That is, if I choose to make real-life movies, which I might eventually. Now, the type of media that I think would be most cool to me were aforementioned movies, but there's also video games and books, like this one book that I have called Celebration of Animation and Animal Encyclopedia, all that stuff. Anything that I think would be like great for nearly anybody would want to see for themselves. Thank you for your time. Hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to like, favorite, subscribe, and always remember that I am here for y'all's entertainment and amusement.